equilibrium state. It is attained in only reversible reactions. It is not present in irreversible reactions. The state at which rate of forward reaction that is equal to rate of backward reaction, that state is called equilibrium state. Consider a reaction A plus B. It gives rise to C plus D. These are reactants and these are products. With time, AB concentrations are decreases, CD concentrations increases. The state at which AB, that is reactants and products concentrations are unchanged, not equal, unchanged, that state is called equilibrium state. It can be represented by using graph. Concentration time. Initially, product concentration is zero and the reactant concentration is highest. Reactant concentration, that means A plus B, their concentration decreases, and product concentration C and D, their concentration increases. After some time, AB and CD concentrations are unchanged. Their concentrations are constant, unchanged. With time, the time at which concentration of reactant products are unchanged, from that time equilibrium state is reached. If we draw a graph between rate and time, initially rate of forward reaction that is highest, backward reaction zero because there is no product. After some time, rate of backward reaction increases, forward reaction decreases. After some time, rate of forward reaction that is equal to, at this time, rate of forward is equal to rate of backward. This state is known as equilibrium state. This is graph between rate of reaction and time. At equilibrium state, rate of forward backward reactions are equal, but concentrations of reactant and product, these are may be equal or may not be equal. In many reactions, these concentrations are not equal but unchanged. Attainment of equilibrium state. The attainment of equilibrium state can be identified by constancy of color, pressure, and concentration, and so on. This constancy, these properties constancy denote the attainment of the equilibrium. It can be studied by using an experiment. Consider two flasks. Flask A and flask B. In flask A, N2O4 is taken. It is taken at 0 degree centigrade temperature. It is a colorless. Gas. Flask B, in this we take nitrogen dioxide, NO2, at 100 degree centigrade. It is a reddish brown. It is a reddish brown gas. Now these two flasks, these are taken at the room temperature. Flask A and B, these two are taken at room temperature. Both the flasks are gain same color, pale brown color. Because at room temperature, N2O4 it dissociate to give NO2, and there is equilibrium exist between nitrogen, dinitrogen tetroxide and nitrogen dioxide. In this also, NO2 dimerizes to give N2O4 NO2. Equilibrium is exist. N2O4 at 0 degree centigrade colorless, NO2 at 100 degree centigrade reddish brown color. When these two are taken at room temperature, N2O4 dissociate to give NO2 and equilibrium exist. NO2 dimerizes to give N2O4 and equilibrium state is exist at room temperature. So there is constancy in color. It clearly indicates the existence of the equilibrium. So existence of equilibrium can be identified by constancy in color, pressure, concentration, density of reactant products and so on.